Hi everybody, it's Amy Valentine, hope you're all good. I thought that since it's a week till Reading Festival starts, I would make a video relating to it because I'm a huge fan of Reading Festival. This year will be my 11th time going to the festival. As a seasoned festivaler, I do have some tips and a good idea of what you kind of need at a festival. So if you are a first timer and you don't know what to pack, or maybe you want to find out some tips, or if you just fancy seeing what I'm taking to Reading Festival, then just carry on watching. So obviously you want to start out with a bag. I would advise against suitcases. You can't drag them easily across grass, and a lot of the time they get ruined, so they're not great to bring. The best thing is one of those huge rucksacks, the Duke of Edinburgh style ones, loads of compartments. It's just really, really good. I saw them last year in Tesco for like 20 quid. So they're definitely the bags that I would advise. Next, obviously, as Reading is a camping festival, look at camping supplies. This year, I am actually not camping. I'm being a bit of a princess. As much fun as camping is, I am working at the festival. I've got to create content and that kind of stuff. I need somewhere to charge up everything the night before, but the camping experience is super fun. In regards to campsites, Green is the closest to the arena. It's generally where a lot of first timers camp. It's basically where everybody walks through. Near the pathways, a lot of tents might get trampled. I don't really like Green that much. Gotta say, my favourite camp is Yellow. We had a really good spot there for a couple of years. We kept going back to that same spot. I've also camped in Orange. Orange is great. They're all pretty great, to be honest. If you want somewhere quiet, go to Brown or White. They do also have Pink Moon camping, which is like, you go there, your tent's already set up. And I did that last year and it was fab. So if you want a bit of an upgrade, you can go do Pink Moon. As for tent security, I did get a question about this. You're just gonna have to hope that no one breaks into your tent. There's no security. I've never been broken into personally, touch wood, and I don't know anybody that has, but just don't keep any valuables in your tent. Cover your food and your alcohol, like hide it somewhere in the tent. It's one of those things, isn't it? All of the tents there are unlocked. I wouldn't advise putting a padlock on your tent though. It might intrigue people, I don't know. So far, everything has been plain sailing. I've never had any problems. My tent is a four-man. I picked it up in Halfords a good few years ago. It served me so well. I think it only cost me about 40 to 60 quid. Just before Reading is the perfect time to get your tent because they're all going to the sale. It's coming to the end of the festival season, so it's definitely worth waiting. Mine has a porch, which is really useful for like taking off wellies and just kind of chilling in there in the morning. And I've used this at a festival probably like over 6 times, I think. I always take it back home with me, and I would advise taking your tent back home. I know it sucks to set down your tent on Monday morning, but it literally takes like 20 minutes, half an hour, and it means you haven't wasted your money, you haven't left the tent behind. It looks like a bloody bomb site on the Monday of Reading Festival. It's kind of depressing how many people leave their tents. It's such a waste. So I would really advise taking your tent home. I always do it. Next, to sleep on, you want to get a roll mat and a sleeping bag. You don't need the roll mat, but it just helps. Sleeping bags you can also get super cheap. My friend Polly actually bought this like sleeping bag air mattress hybrid. It comes all as one thing. I'll try and link it below. It was only like 30 quid and it looked amazing. Saves you carrying lots of stuff. I've brought in air mattresses before. Obviously it is a bit of a pain because you need to bring a pump. I never brought a pump because I just banked on someone else having one and I managed to find them, but you know, it's a risk. I've also done it before when I've taken one duvet for underneath me and another duvet for on top. It just kind of depends how you want to play it. Sleeping bag is probably the easiest thing to do. To carry it all, you can either strap things onto your big rucksack or you could bring like a trolley. I've had like big pull-along trolleys or like one of those, the forklift, not like a forklift, but yeah, the ones with like the two things that come out and like that. It really does suck taking everything into the campsite, but everybody manages to do it. It's not that difficult. Now we'll go through like general stuff. I've got a couple things down here I can show you. First up, baby wipes. I don't actually have any baby wipes here. They're just all around useful for mud. You can have a baby wipe shower because I personally have never showered at a festival. Not really that bothered. Then obviously toilet roll is helpful. Toilets tend to run out quite quickly, but in the past couple years it's not been too bad. But the campsite toilets, you do need this because they are fucking gross. Also bin bags. Bin bags have always been super helpful. Like I would not go to a festival without bin bags. You always need them. Put wet clothes in it, rubbish, taking stuff home, you know, whatever. They're just really, really handy. Then I have a kind of like a medical stuff bag. I like to put stuff in bags like this because then they're really easy to spot and you kind of know what's in them. So we'll go through. First up, I have Tums. I get really bad like heartburn and stuff. These are just really good for neutralizing your stomach acid. I always have these. Next up, paracetamol. Obviously if you're hungover in the morning, you've got a bit of a headache, or in the day, something like that, really useful to have. Either paracetamol or ibuprofen. I don't really know the difference. Blister plasters, always really handy. It is the worst thing at a festival when you've got blisters, so these are great to have. Sun cream. This is the Pisbeen one day long SPF 15. I tend to tan all right, so I don't need that much of a high SPF. England's starting to get really hot and the weather for this year of Reading is hopefully going to be really nice and sunny, so make sure you bring this. Otherwise you'll burn and that's going to suck, and also skin cancer. Next up, I've got this little box. It's got my earplugs in it. These are handy for both sleeping. The campsites get really noisy. Or also, if you're by a speaker at a band, useful to have sometimes. It's never happened to me, but I know that you can get tinnitus if you are too close to amps and stuff. Like, you can damage your hearing pretty bad. There's also 3 sleeping tablets in there. I wouldn't advise these. These are just in here from my flight to LA. I wouldn't take these if I was drinking. Maybe there are sleeping tablets that you can take if you are drinking, but just be really careful with that kind of stuff. That's how Michael Jackson died, isn't it? Then I have a sleep mask because I hate being woken up by light at like 7 a.m. This is from Urban Outfitters, it says fuck off on it. I enjoy it very much. And then as I take my phone to festivals, not something I would really advise because obviously there's a lot of risks. I've lost my phone at download before. Luckily I got it back because people are awesome. Be careful if you don't want to bring your phone, bring a crappy Nokia or something. But obviously I've got to create content for the festivals. I do take my phone and therefore I need portable chargers. This one is pretty good. It's got like 2 chargers in it. I don't have one of those really good ones with like 4 chargers, but I'll try and link one below. I was given this in a festival kit a couple years ago. It's decent. The solar panel doesn't work. Like it's a bit of a gimmick. It's never really worked for me. Yeah, obviously if you want power, these are handy. Also, it's a nightmare trying to find stuff in your tent at nighttime and you don't want to waste the battery in your phone using it as a torch. So bring a torch with you. I have a normal torch, but I couldn't find it. And I also bring my head torches. These are the shit. Honestly, this is the best thing ever. You can be hands-free, looking fab. What more could you want? Moving on to like beauty and stuff. I always take my makeup, obviously. Here is my makeup bag. It's from eBay and you can like put your brushes in it. I'll try and link this below. This is pretty big. I haven't downsized for the sake of the video, but I always try and take just what I need and what I know I'll use because there's actually a lot of stuff in my makeup bag that I just don't use. Also, I advise with foundation, especially if you use an expensive one. Obviously, if your foundation is subject to extreme temperature changes, as with most makeup actually, it can kind of ruin. So I have these little sample bottles. If you don't want to risk your nice Estee Lauder foundation being ruined, this is a good idea. You can ask for them in makeup counters like House of Fraser or Debenhams or something like that. Next, we'll go into my toiletries bag. I got this really cute one from Cat's Eye London. Obviously, you want a toothbrush. This one's actually electric. Next, we're gonna bring toothpaste. I got this really small one. It's really handy. Smaller the better, really, because you don't want them to take up space. And this wash bag is so good as well because it's got like this pocket in the side where I keep my toothbrush so it's not like mixed in with everything. Next up, a hairbrush. This is my Tangle Teaser. I love these things. Next up, roll-on deodorant. You're not allowed aerosols over 250 milliliter, and I don't use spray-on deodorant anyway because it's bad for the environment, and roll-on is fine. So this is the Mitchum 24-hour fresh antiperspirant one. Then we have dry shampoo. This is the chlorine one. It's really cute and diddy, and this is 50 milliliters. You are allowed to take aerosols under 250 milliliters. Stops your hair getting greasy, obviously. I also take hair oil. I don't use a specific brand, just whatever I have at the moment. I tend to get them a lot in goodie bags. At the moment, I'm using this Schwarzkopf Got to Be Oil-licious. As my hair starts to get dirty, it gets oil at the roots, but really, really dry at the ends. So it's very important that I keep it nourished and nice. Then I have a mini moisturizer. This is a molten brown one. Found this in the bathroom. It's probably from a hotel or something like that, and these are the best things to bring because obviously they're very small. You don't need to take a whole huge moisturizer with me. Next up, makeup wipes. These are Which ones. They are anti-blemish cleansing toning wipes. Quickly removes makeup and dirt. They're fab. They're great for when you're drunk, you just want to get all your makeup off, so do recommend. Also, suncream for your face. This one is Dermaquest SPF 30. A lot of the time though, I will use 50 on my face. My face doesn't tan anyway. Like, look at the difference of my face and my body. And the sun is aging, so just put suncream on your face. If you want to look more tanned, you can use fake tan or use bronzer. Just protect your face, it's very important. Also, you'll want to bring lots of hair bubbles, hair ties, whatever. When it gets hot, if you want to do some cool festival hairstyles, keep one on your wrist or something. They always come in handy. As for skincare, I actually did a whole video on my festival skincare routine, so I will link that in the description. You can see everything that I would take. I don't want to waste time and go through it all again when it's literally, I did a whole video on it. So check that out. Moving on to clothing. I'm not going to show you what I'm wearing because I will be doing a lookbook from the festival, but I thought I'd give you some general clothing tips. Shoes wise, this year is looking to be quite hot and nice, so you could get away with wearing some boots like Doc Martens or like Chelsea boots. I don't know, something that's really comfortable. You have to make sure that they're comfortable. I love the cat boots as well. I've worn them for a good few festivals. They're good for mud, not when it's like super, super like puddle mud, but hopefully it doesn't get like that this year at Reading. Download, they would not have worked. And obviously if it starts to get super rainy, you're going to need to bring wellies. I have some from this brand Moyon Leaf, but very sadly, I think that they've shut down their online store. Wellies are wellies. I love Hunter, but they're a bit pricey. Just whatever floats your boat. I do usually bring a pair of wellies as like a backup. Next up, you need to make sure that you take warm clothes. I always take a really, really warm jumper and a couple of jackets. There's nothing worse than being cold, and there's nothing you can do about it. It does get really, really cold at night, so make sure you do bring some warm stuff. Especially fluffy socks. These are a lifesaver. I get so cold at night and my feet get absolutely freezing, so I usually will wear 2 pairs of socks. This is just from Primark. I would never go to a festival without fluffy socks. Then just in case it rains, you might want to bring a waterproof jacket. You can get those like poncho, the rain ponchos, the small ones, or a cagoule is really good, the ones that like fold from a bag into a jacket. But I have a Dry Star and I love it so much. I've used this a few times. It looks like this. I'll put in a cutaway of me wearing it. This thing is super waterproof. Any water just completely falls off. I know a lot of waterproofs, they're like shower proof, they're not actually waterproof, but this is so fab. It's got really big pockets, keeps you very, very dry, so that is just ideal. The plasticky ponchos just get annoying and they get ripped and they're not really that good. And lastly, you you don't want to forget sunglasses. I have to have sunglasses most days. A couple of examples I have here. These are both from Zero UV. Don't bring any designer sunglasses. Just don't bother. They might get ruined or lost. I've lost many pairs of sunglasses at festivals, so make sure you bring a couple backups. Try to make sure that they have UV protection in them. Obviously, your eyes can get pretty damaged from the sun. As for bags, obviously, rucksacks are kind of the generally gravitated towards for festivals because you can get a lot of stuff in them. But I really hate bringing rucksacks because a lot of the time, obviously, you're seeing a band, you're in the crowd, your rucksack gets like pushed into your back. I've had it before when it's been so tight in the crowd, my bag has been like pushing my torso out. Really, really hurt. I like bum bags. Bum bags are the way forward. These things are what you want. This is what you want. This is my favorite bum bag, because look at all of the compartments. I believe this is vintage from Rocket Vintage. This is where you can put all your money, the one that's close to you, so you can't get pickpocketed and stuff. You can pick them up from all over. You can pick them up at the festival. I've packed a couple things in it, so let's go through. So first thing in here is this. It's my camera case. I'm currently filming on my camera, so I can't show you. I will have my camera with me, but I would say maybe take a disposable camera. I love how pictures turn out on those. The ultimate kind of festival kind of vibe. I love film so much. I always get a disposable camera. I just haven't got one yet. Next up is my phone. I've actually put on a case with a mirror on the back. This is from Touch Zero Gravity, and I've got this on because then you can see how you're looking just on your phone. So I'll link this case below. Next up, my powder. This is the Soap and Glory One Heck of a Blot. I love this stuff. It's got a little powder puff in it. I really like it. Next, Vaseline. My lips get really dry all the time, so I use this a lot. Then we have anti-bac gel. I rely on this stuff so much at festivals. It's amazing. This one is from Bath and Body Works. I got it in America. Then I have a portable charger, and it's a quite a small one. It's only got like one charge in it, but it's better than taking one of those chunky ones out with you. Then on the strap of the bag, I have one of these. This is from Primark, but you can get them all around. It's a floppy water bottle. At the moment, it's rolled up because it's empty. When you want to put stuff on it, you unclip it and roll it down. This holds a surprisingly large amount of liquid, which is perfect for festivals. You've got to stay hydrated. Like, it's the most important thing, especially if it's hot. These are the best bottles to have. I love them. So that's what's in my festival bag. If you're looking for more of a jazzy bum bag, I have this one. This is really fun. I really like having my compartments though, so this has just got one big compartment. But yeah, if you want something a bit more festively fun, this is really fab. This is from Jaded London. Next is food and drink. I tend to buy most of my meals at festivals, but I will never buy breakfast. Actually, no, that's not true. I will go get a coffee. Food wise, I will always bring cereal bars. This one is a Eat Natural one I found in my cupboard. It's Brazil and Sultana. That sounds fucking gross. I usually bring the brunch bars with the chocolate on them, or like the Alpen strawberry ones. Definitely not fucking Sultanas. I wanted an example to show you, so there you go. Then meal wise, I've done it in the past where I've taken a couple of pot noodles with me. I tend to be lazy and just buy most of my meals there, but these are really handy for if you want to save some money. A meal there is like 6 to 8 quid, maybe even more, so these are great. For hot water, go to like a Samaritan stand. Just give a small donation of your choice. You don't have to, it's suggested, and they will give you some hot water for free. Or you could go to a food van that serves coffee or something and ask them, but I always go to the Samaritan tent. I tend to have these when I'm in the campsite and they're pretty close. Then you want to bring snacks, preferably stodgy things just to keep you going. I've got some mini cheddars here because they're fab. Crisps as well you can bring. Just something to give you some energy. Doing a lot of jumping around, you're going to need some more food. I've also done before when I brought my Graze boxes to the festival as more of like a healthy snack. And last of all, you gotta take some booze. My personal favorite is a box of wine. This is actually pretty much empty. You're not allowed to bring any glass into the festival at all. So leave the glass at home. Dilute anything in glass bottles, just do a plastic bottle. If you like wine, this is the way forward. There's about 3 bottles in here. This is Sainsbury's house, it's super cheap. I usually go for rosé because it's my favorite. Vodka, cider, whatever. Just make sure that you don't bring any glass in because you will get it taken off you and that money will be wasted. And lastly, I always tend to bring a really big bottle with me to fill with water because it's so important to stay hydrated. So it's the best thing to do. They have taps all around the campsites for you to refill them. Stay hydrated, kids. So yeah, that's everything on my list. I hope I didn't miss too much off. If you guys have any tips on what to bring to Reading Festival that maybe I've missed out, make sure that you leave them in the comments below. Help some people out, you know. If you want some more advice or tips for Reading Festival, as I've said, I'm pretty experienced in this field and I wrote a blog post last year, which I will also link in the description bar. I spent hours on this thing and it's pretty long and detailed. Anyway, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Make sure you give it a thumbs up if you are coming to Reading this year. Make sure if you see me, come say hello. I love meeting you guys. I'm so excited for Reading this year. Like, the lineup looks insane. So pumped to see Diane Wood, 21 Pilot, Foles, Biffy, Fall Out Boy. The lineup is just insane. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.